Okay. So, let's look around here a bit. There's all these cleaning trolleys around, but no cleaning people. Will they just let me walk out then? What's this? I can't read that language. Okay, it's just going to keep scrolling up and down. Oh, there's a cleaning person. Just as I was saying, there weren't any around.
If it's for a regular checkup, the doctor's offices are behind the reception area.
Thank you. Can't I talk to the receptionist? She looks a bit...
Excuse me.
Yes?
I'm looking for Dr. Zamiatine.
He's in his office. You'll find it in the small corridor back there, the first door on your left.
Pretty gloomy clinic. It could do with a bit of human warmth.
It used to be the fortress of the Dukes of Valsimbor, the ancient rampart standing against invasions from the east. The inhabitants of Valsimbor took refuge here and often escaped the besiegers through mysterious secret passages.
When did it become a clinic?
That was 20 years ago, thanks to Dr. Zamiatine.
All right, exit.
I would like to leave this clinic. Would you mind telling me where the exit is, please?
Well, usually I'd have told you to go over to the other side of the courtyard to take the funicular that goes down to Valsimbor. But it seems Dr. Efimova has shut off the entire clinic for security reasons. The funicular has been stopped until further orders.
I see. Thank you for all that information. I'll be going now.
Maybe you should head on back to your room and wait until they say the funicular is fixed and back in service.
I'll think about it. Goodbye.
So you live in the clinic then? And the cleaner does too? Surely there's a way out. And also, it's only a slight thing that bothers me, but her voice did not match her face at all. Like, it was like a relatively an older lady, and her voice sounded like a young 20-something girl. I don't know if that is the casting's fault, or maybe they changed what they wanted the receptionist to look like at the end. But it didn't fit well. And I've noticed that with some of the patients as well that we talked to upstairs, the one that were playing chess or something. Me talk to them, their voice did not really match their look. They sounded a lot younger than what they looked like.
I'm here to see my husband. He's been here months and months.
Yeah, that's fairly okay.
I've been waiting for my appointment for hours.
You see, these voices are all right. Assuming this is the doctor.
Ah, hello, Miss Walker. How very delightful to see you up and about. Even if I really have to admit that I'm a bit surprised, our dear Dr. Olga painted a far darker picture of your current state of health.
She would.
I don't want to say anything bad about someone you seem to appreciate, Dr. Zamiatine, but quite frankly, Dr. Efimova worries me.
Ah, and why is that?
She and her associate, Dr. Mangling, put me through a real interrogation. They're also keeping Kirk, the young Youkol, prisoner, attached to his bed. Not to mention the psychological grip she seems to have on everybody here.
Listen to me, Miss Walker. I know that waking up after a prolonged period in a coma is difficult. In such a context, anxiety attacks are very normal. But please, do not project it onto Dr. Olga. I'm not getting any younger, you know, and running this clinic is a very heavy burden. The last few years, Olga has shown she is capable of assisting me. I have every faith in her.
But...
The subject is closed, Miss Walker.
Right.
Please tell me about that pendant you have around your neck. I must admit I noticed it as soon as you walked in.
It's a souvenir.
It's a souvenir.
Of a good memory or a bad one?
Both.
Both at once, really.
Of course. Just like with all memories, right? At any rate, what's currently important for you is to avoid being too haunted.
Dr. Zamiatine, I promised Kirk I'd go to the craftsman in Valsambor and bring back his mechanical prosthesis. The poor boy has been waiting for it for ages, so I'd like to try to speed up the process. Would you tell me how to get there?
Now there's a truly noble initiative, Miss Walker. I asked my clockmaker friend Simon Steiner to manufacture the young Youkol's mechanical prosthetic leg. He's a capable craftsman and ingenious. You'll find him in his workshop. Near the Valsambor port. I imagine he must almost be finished with his work by now. He makes amazing things. You'll see.
Can you authorize my release so that I can see Dr. Steiner? Unfortunately, I've been told that the clinic is in lockdown.
You will have to ask Dr. Olga, Miss Walker. She signed the current order to lock our establishment down. She's in charge of giving out the passes.
She'll not give me one.
This book should answer any of the questions you may have about our Youkol's friends. Farewell and bon voyage, Miss Walker.
Why, thank you. Racism. What?
How many ostrich migrations have you seen?
This is the third one. I'm lucky to have seen so many of them. It's a rare spectacle, believe me. The great herd of ostriches accompanied by the Youkols, doomed to blindly follow their animals wherever they happen to roam. And they don't care about countries, wars, and borders.
You seem to like the Youkols, Dr. Zamiatine.
They are a fascinating people, you know, and such astonishing medicine infused with shamanism. Without which, no doubt you would have never arrived in this clinic alive, Miss Walker.
True.
Why did the Youkols ask you to heal Kirk?
On each of their migrations, the Youkol shamans and I have exchanged medical knowledge. Their trance therapy and materia medica have provided astounding results for my patients affected by psychological afflictions. In exchange, I do what I can to take care of those injured that they can't heal using their traditional medicine. Like, that poor boy who lost his leg.
True. Yeah, I'm assuming she'll just ask about the racism towards the Youkol.
I get the impression that the Youkols aren't much liked around here.
Indeed. It would seem that most of the inhabitants of Valsambor are now quite hostile towards them. This wasn't the case a while back, you know. When I was young, the migration of the snow ostriches was an event widely welcomed with open arms in Valsambor.
Why the change in attitude?
Our region was actually somewhat devastated 20 years ago. Dramatic events changed the way people viewed the world. The people turned inward on themselves. They're less welcoming. And the fact that the Youkols have been stuck here, next to Lake Valsambor for several weeks, hasn't helped.
It's really necessary for me to ask Olga's permission to leave? You're the director of this clinic, after all.
Olga is my right-hand woman. I can't keep her uninvolved in current matters, Miss Walker. She is also currently your doctor. You should really talk with her about it. She isn't as evil as you seem to believe. You'll find her in her office, most probably.
Interesting he should use the word evil when it comes to her, because that's not a word that, Kate used, and in the real world, that's not really a word someone would use. They'd say she's not as difficult or strict or mean, but evil. That's a special word. Where is Dr. Olga, though? This is no help. Can I talk? Does the receptionist know?
What about going back to your room? If you like, I can go and ask Dr. Mangling to come get you.
No. I guess I'll just take the lift. If I can get there. Why did they place so many pillars in this hall?
No way I'm going back upstairs.
Oh, okay. So where is Dr. Olga then? Do I need to talk to her? Is there any other way I can get out? What's in that book he gave me? Okay, it's in the journal? Yes. Wait. I can't read that. Okay. All right. Oh, so do I have to? Oh, wow. Why didn't they just make it a book I could read normally? So. Yes, so that's Cornelius Pons, the professor from the first game, whose lecture we attended, and who we helped by giving him the mammoth doll to study. Again, some weird controller choices here. Why can't I just leaf through the book and read it as is, like in previous games? Why do I have to leaf through it and then press the read button to actually be able to read it in this weird layout? I see no reason for that to be like it is. They could have just made it a readable book. I assume it's all got to do with being optimized for consoles, maybe? I don't know if it's been released on console. I assume so, considering the controller preference and the bigger letters. If you sit far away from your screen, I assume this is easier to read. So far, nothing really interesting, just some backstory that we heard already better in the first and mainly the second game. The first one as well. This looks like the entrance to the shaman's hut in the first game. We had a Yuki once. It was very useful. Wonder if we left it on the Mammoth Island, Siberia. We've seen it. We've been there. Now they're tying in the snow ostrich migration with the previous games on this page. So they shifted their dependence from mammoths to the snow ostriches. They remind me of the good side of the Skeksis in the Dark Crystal. I can't remember what they were called. You had the Skeksis, which was the evil ones, and then you had the good ones, and I can't remember their name. But that's what they look like to me, like the front of them. Their neck and face. Last page, I hope. Yep. All right. So they don't really go into any part of why suddenly there is a migration, and they didn't mention it before. They just explain that it was always there. I'll accept it. Pretty paintings everywhere. I'm not usually too bothered by inconsistencies between sequels. It's just what happens, isn't it? If it's too different, I tend to treat it like a different game, like the difference between Fallout 2 and Fallout 3. To me, I like both of them for very different reasons. So.
The American is awake. You must hurry, Colonel.
How is she doing?
Fine, apparently. She is docile for the moment. This may not last too much longer, I'm afraid.
And what about the tribe of nomads?
Just like the past 2 years, Lake Valsambor hasn't frozen over, so the herd can't cross the ice. They're stuck here. And also, their young guide is still in our control. If everything goes as planned, soon the Youkols will have no choice but to go back home. Especially as I have a plan to speed things up.
Fine.
There's also the American detective, Colonel. He should be arriving soon.
Mm-hmm. Let him meet with Miss Walker if that's what he wants to do. No point alarming him just yet. But when all is said and done, we're the ones who are handling the young woman's case. No American is going to come here and tell us what to do.
What? Where did she go?
Secret entrance. Not so secret entrance, I guess. By the detective, I assume they mean the detective that was chasing us in the second game. And I was kind of hoping, actually, that they would dig him up for this game, too. it would only make sense that he also... Because he chased her.
All sorts of sedatives and tranquilizers.
That he would show up somewhere near where Kate was, eventually, unless he died. But that would be sad.